Hello again, folks. That's right, you're looking at Doc Martin for KRAZ-TV. And this is Arizona Channel News Live. Yeah, we're on countdown to World War III, day 14. Anyway, on PBS last night, they had a Lieutenant Colonel Davis. He came in and was giving an assessment about how things ain't looking as good rosy as they said they were in front of Congress. So we'll see what happens with that. Anyways, I did a little solar fair a couple years ago, and I want everybody to see this. It's out in Tucson at Himmel Park on Hippie Hill.
Well, Doc Martin here. We're going to have a short interview with Jody. She helped put this festival together, and she's bringing in some props right now. We're going to have a live interview, and she's going to explain what this is all about. It's the environment, and is it today called Synergistic Water Festival?
Well, it's a three-day festival.
Yes.
Three-day festival. It's the Water Project Tucson Synergistic Water Festival, and it's from March 26th to the 28th. The first day had a film festival. Today we're here at Solar Rock. We just did a festival performance, and then tomorrow we have a bunch of activities. It starts off in Sabino Canyon with a cross-cultural interfaith water ritual. And then we go to Armory Park Center, where we'll have an Enviro Vendor Fair. We'll have a policy panel discussion. We'll have roundtable brainstorms on many different topics of water issues. We'll do the festival performance again. And then we'll have a closing ceremony where we pour the water from the water urn from Sabino Canyon.
Wow.
Then we have an after party.
Cool.
Which will be catered and live music. And then after that, there's an after party at People's Imports. So full schedule.
People's Imports, people.
Yeah. So it's a wonderful event to raise awareness to water issues here in Tucson, which has a ripple effect abroad.
We need that very much.
Absolutely. Yes. And so we're here, we're trying to address the water issues in a creative and proactive way. So that's the mission.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Doc Martin here again. That's right, folks. You've heard it first, and we're here live. Wait, let me get a shot of this.
Here's a fish.
I love that fish. It's as big as her. May all fish be as big as you.
Right.
Goodbye, and we'll see you soon.
Okay.
Bye. Well, folks, I'm back again. This is Doc Says with KRAZ-TV.com, your Tucson Internet TV premiere, showing since 1997, and yes, we were green long before that, but you know, we are here and we got the last synergistic thing about the water. So we want to know about the Green Tea Party. And here's a person to tell us. How are you, sir?
Yes, fine. My name's D.B. Walt. I'm with a local nonprofit called Natural System Solutions and also with a grassroots organization called Transition Pima. One of the things we're doing is getting people to think about what sustainability really means and come to the understanding that it can be defined both in an ecologically sound manner as well as a legally defensible manner. And in doing so, what we're trying to do is get the Mayor and Council in Tucson and the Pima County Board of Supervisors to adopt that definition of sustainability to act as a foundation for planning, land use, zoning, and actually start looking at the things we're doing and be able to tell whether or not they truly are sustainable or not.
All right, well, thank you very much. What's the Green Tea Party about?
Well, the Green Tea Party is just kind of it's more a play on words more than anything else.
Yeah, you know, but you're not affiliated with the known Tea Party.
No,
somehow we're all affiliated with each other.
Yeah, the Tea Party patriots tend to spend too much of their time railing about what they're against, and what we're doing is getting people to start thinking about what can we be for. What can
That's
we
exactly
do
right. I'm with you there. Exactly. Thank you. So sign the petition.
Sign the petition.
And sign the symbolic teabag version, and I will sign both.
Okay.
So I'll be right back, folks, as I sign this petition for the Green Tea Party petition at the Solar Rock Festival and Fair at Himmel Park in Tucson, this March 27, 2010. Thank you and keep watching.
All right, folks. You know, I talked to Dave, and he was talking to us about the Green Tea Party, but we also found out that he makes transition trailers. And I tell you, you know, I've got a pet thing about human-powered vehicles and solar energy and all. But anyways, he started showing me some of these things. A lot of his power and everything is coming from these little towed solar cell units. They may not be what I designed, but I think they're quite innovative. And that's right. His whole PA system, his power conversion, and solar cell are all in one unit here. And he's even using that to power his spacer bar, to power the charger, that powers the bicycle, and the smart wheel in the bicycle powers the bicycle. So it's one person's or one family's little system of being green. Now I'm going to ask him online. He makes some of these trailers. These are transition trailers. And this is test drive. So they have a bicycle here where you can try one of their little trailers. So here's a covered one. And there's an uncovered trailer. Maybe we can get one of these folks to tell us what a transition trailer is. Would you like to tell us?
I would let him tell you since okay. He is the builder and the man who knows, has all okay. The answers to all the questions.
Okay, all right. Because they don't have solar cells on them. They don't have lights.
They can come with them, exactly.
Well, do you?
I'd like to interview you.
Yeah, will you tell me about your trailers? I showed the public your little PA and voltage conversion and battery storage system with all of that. And then I showed the bicycle that was being charged from that system and now the smart wheel on all of that. But you have transition trailers. What is a transition trailer?
Well, a transition trailer is a way to get people to start thinking about how they're going to get around, how are we going to transition once people start realizing that we're past the peak of global oil production. And so we're looking at how do we transition into a sustainable future. And one of the things about transition is we need to also understand that we're not asking people to move back to the caves and don hair shirts or things
That's
like that.
That's true.
So we're going to have technology, but we need to start looking about how can we create methods of right livelihood
on
a neighborhood scale on products that actually contribute to lowering our carbon footprint.
And you don't need a car to go to the grocery store if you live three blocks away. Exactly.
Or you do most of your other shopping.
That's right. You can carry it, folks, right on one of these. That's an open-air model, I see.
That's the open-air model.
And then you have this closed style.
The closed style, this one I actually use. I can put my welder, all my tools, my work materials and stuff, and go out to job site.
Wow.
So they'll carry 200-300 pounds fairly easily.
You know, I saw guys carrying all their landscaping equipment on bicycles, and I did that 5 years ago. Yeah. Everybody said that was campy.
Yeah.
It's campy.
Yeah.
Well, folks, stay in the green camp. Join the green camp. We'll be right back. And I'm going to get back with you, folks. You've got to get back. Let me get one of David's transition trailer brochures. May I have one?
Sure, man.
And we will put you on the internet with your address and telephone number. It's Transition Industries, 520-887-2502. That's right. We'll be right back.
That's right, folks. We're at the Solar Rock Fair, Rock Festival. GE Innovations, we just talked with some of the peace groups, the transition group of trailers, Dave, Synergistic Water Festival, Sun Power, and we're all here, that's right, showing all this happening at this little place, and there's Hippie Hill up in the background, KXCI, we know them, don't we, folks? That's right, Community Radio helped put this on. As we go through this solar fair, here's PV Recycling, LLC. Looks like they're going to have their own little show here. I hear something buzzing. We better check it out and see what it is. I see we have the solar store here. We have Pima County Department of Environmental Quality.
we have the solar store. Wow. Wow, we have the little fountain driven by this panel. Well, I can feel the heat off of that. You're not cooking anything in there, though. Wow. You should have some corn or something going. I met the owner of this store once. That's a great little idea, folks.
Folks, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching Arizona Channel News. And just remember, everything I said here is BTJMO, but that's just my opinion. So I'll see you later. Keep watching, and thanks. Come back again to the Rincon Market. Goodbye.